Hello all. I, Shafreena Dongre, welcome you all once again. Today, we are going to discuss the glossary related to bread. It will help you to brush up your knowledge regarding the various terminologies used related to bread making. So let's discuss. First is lean dough. Bread dough, which has a very less amount of fat and sugar, is called as a lean dough. Pizza base is a very common example which has been made using the lean dough. Next is rich dough. The dough which has high amount of fat, sugar, and eggs in it is known as rich dough. So the brioche or creuse would be the example of rich dough. Next is rolled in dough. These are the doughs which has fat incorporated in it using the rolling and folding technique, which is also known as lamination. It can be done for sweet dough like Danish, or it can also be done for unsweetened dough like creuse. The next word is straight dough method. This is a bread making method in which all the ingredients are mixed together and kneaded to make a dough. Next word is sponge and dough method. In this bread making method, a ferment is made using the entire amount of water and some amount of flour, the texture of which resembles that of a sponge, and hence the name. Depending upon the amount of flour used, whether 25%, 50%, or 75%, the method will derive its name, whether it is quarter sponge, half sponge, or three-quarter sponge. The next term is no-time dough method. In this bread-making method, the amount of yeast is increased. The volume of the bread is quite good, but the typical yeasty flavor in the bread is missing because of the insufficient time given for the fermentation. The next word is punching. It is one of the steps in bread making where, after the bulk fermentation, the dough is punched. It is also known as knockback. This process helps to expel the air, because of which the distribution of the yeast is done. The temperature of the dough is equalized, and it also helps to soften the gluten. The next word is rounding. After dividing and scaling, the dough is rounded off and the edges are sealed. As is shown in the picture, the open ends, if kept like that, will result in expulsion of air, which is also termed as bleeding. So to avoid the bleeding, this rounding has been done. It also helps to give proper shape to the final product. Next word is windscreen test or window pane test. As is shown in the picture, a small quantity of dough is stretched between the fingers. If the dough doesn't tear in between, it is the indication of proper gluten development. The next word is oven spring. The initial and sudden rise in the volume of bread, once it is put inside the oven, it is known as oven spring. The next word is artisan breads. The bread which is handmade using pre-ferment or sourdough starter and does not use preservatives can be termed as artisan bread. It may or may not include traditional baking methods. Next is hard bread. The bread which is baked directly on the floor of an oven, which is mostly fired by wood, is known as hard bread. As is shown in the picture, pizza is very commonly used, or it is very commonly baked as hearth bread. Next word is ottolee. To improve the gluten structure and handling of the final dough, the baker mixes the flour and water while making the artisan bread, and this dough is rested for half an hour. This process of mixing the flour and water and resting it for half an hour is known as ottolee. As is being told, this ottolee process is mostly adapted while making the artisan bread. Next word is poolish. It is a thin bread dough starter originated in Poland. It uses equal quantity of flour and water and some amount of yeast depending upon the rate of fermentation which is required. The next word is biga, which is an Italian term for pre-ferment. Next word is sourdough. This is a type of bread made using sourdough starters, which is fermented by wild yeast present in the air. The next word is levain. This is the term used for pre-ferment in France. Next word is bloom. The natural shine on top of bread is known as bloom. It is an indication of good quality and craftsmanship. Scoring. It means giving slits with a sharp blade on the bread for decorative purposes. Whether to slit or not to slit depends on the baker, but baguette is the only bread which is always scored. Crumb is the word given to the netted structure of bread concealed in a crust. Next word is lye. Mix of caustic soda and water is known as lye. It is especially used for pretzel, where the proof pretzels are dipped in lye and sprinkled with sea salt. This caustic soda gives drying effect to the throat and facilitates extra consumption of beer during the October Beer Fest. Next word is mold. It is a bread disease caused by fungus and is visible in the form of black spots on the bread. Next word is rope. Again, it is a bread disease caused by bacteria present in flour. Unhygienic conditions is a major contributor for rope. Thank you very much for watching the video. I hope it will be useful for you. Kindly attempt the quiz given in the description box. Thank you very much.